mostly we the homeopaths generally practicing chronic cases, and most of our institution also teaches the students that homeopathy is really good for chronic cases, no doubt of it. But my dear doctors, remember that we have really a lots of medicine through which we can tackle, we can control, we can cure the acute situations. Any type of acute situations, maybe it is fever, maybe it is pain in abdomen, maybe it is headache, maybe it is cough, cold, coryza, where our modern medicine is failed and our medicines are acting very nicely. I am giving some examples that how quickly we the younger generations can treat the disease which is prevailing at any moment, any time surrounding you. Suppose cough, cold, coryza. Mostly we know that in acute cough, cold, coryza, either some sorts of analgesics, some sorts of bronchodilators, some sorts of antibiotics, they are prescribing. But with our small doses of aconite, belladonna, rustax, dalcamara, justicia, osimum sancum, very nicely we can control our cough and cold. And more we know this acute application of homeopathy, more we will get the pleasure that how beautiful our science is. Suppose winter, a child all of a sudden develop high rise of temperature, all on a sudden, suppose it was his birthday or her birthday, gala gathering, it was cold, on the roof they played till 9 p.m., till 6 p.m., all on a sudden you got a call from the mother, doctor, all on a sudden my child has high rise of temperature, restlessness, crying, and what you can do? The congestion, the cold air exposure with sudden onset, successfully we can tackle this case with aconite. So you have to know the inner essence of every medicine, that acuteness, suddenness and restlessness and congestion is exposure to dry cold wind. Though in our Materia Medica it is written that fear, yes, fear may be associated, but remember that when congestion is fear, then aconite can be thought of even in chronic cases. Like for these examples, that remember that differentiation in case of acute attack, aconite has dry skin. That you have to remember. And whenever the symptom is changing, that sudden attack, violent attack, child is crying all on a sudden, pain comes rapidly, going rapidly, but skin is moist, perspiration is coming, that is the stage of belladonna. So by this way, more you differentiate, more confidently you can prescribe, that even in acute conditions, how beautifully we can tackle. Now the same child, after exposure, developing fever, and with some, you are observing, doctor, and mother is telling that he has developing that abdominal respiration and with some whistling, shh, 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 shh. So you are observing, you are listening, mother is listening, you are also listening through stethoscope, and with that nausea, some child is either gagging or vomiting, or even after vomiting the persisting nausea is there. See the tongue, and it is clean tongue, and mother is telling with this fever, respiratory distress, mostly stools are greenish. Start with ipecac, and you will see that how magically the ipecac can control the acute stress of this type of respiratory distress, or even the early stress of the bronchitis. So this clean tongue, nausea, and this type of dry first stage of bronchial asthma or even bronchitis, respiratory distress, here we are prescribing Ipecac. The same patient, suppose giving another picture, that after the exposure, the patient is developing some sorts of runny nose, is sneezing, dry cough, and you are observing that associated with patient has developed constipation. Constipation is sneezing, and dry cough start with justicia adatoda. Actually, this is the way you have to think that how quickly we can tackle this situation. The same patient after cough, cold, kuraija, you are observing that you all of a sudden you are observing, my goodness, his lips are red, tongue is red, and so much irritable, pulling the hair, spitting, aggressive, and mother is unable to control. So much irritability is there. So irritability with red lip, with acute cough, cold, coryza, sneezing, think of opossumum sanctum, that redness. So more you know these acute tips, more you will be successful and confident, yes, we also can do. The another patient in cough, cold, coryza, that is dry cough, unproductive cough. And every time you are observing that during coughing, the child holding the chest by the two hands, constipated and unwilling to be disturbed. Patient is always lying on the bed. And if anybody is asking, take fruits, take your meal, take your breakfast. No, desire to be remain on bed, obstinate constipation, coated tongue, not to be disturbed. As if in a hotel it is written, not to be disturbed. If you observe this and better by pressure, unproductive cough, think of bryonia. And most of the time you will get that bryonia causation, exposure to dry cold air. And it is hot, must be it is during summer weather. Not exactly dry cold weather, but it must be that is the summer weather exposure. In aconite you are getting exposure to dry cold air. And bryonia, generally it happens after sun exposure. Like that, another patient you will get that it is a rainy weather, exposure to dry cold air, and patient has started with runny nose, sneezing. And he needs two or three handkerchiefs to control that coryza, that nasal discharge. And if you get really that all on a sudden he was walking and sudden rain exposure, and after that he develops this with lot of mucus secretion, excessive mucus secretion, think of dalgamna. And dalgamna is a medicine, doctors, that very, very often we are puzzled that whether we will prescribe dalgamna or rastax, dalgamna or rastax. Why? Because in rastax also you will get congestion is sudden change of weather, especially after rain exposure. Rheumatism, pain in abdomen, pain in the muscle pain, fever, everything you will get. But remember that even urticaria, especially after rain exposure, if patient started itching, producing urticaria, that is a very common phenomena, where to prescribe dalgamna and where to prescribe rastax, it is a confusion. But remember, doctor, that rastax not only your restless, always moving, gesturing, changing the position, but rastax better by warm application. In urticaria, itching followed by burning, and better by warm application, and congestion when it is our rain exposure, think of rastax. But in dalgamna you will get eruption, urticaria, no fever, remember, no fever. And the funny thing is that congestion is cold exposure, but dalgamna is always better with cold application. That is the funniest thing. And more we know this type of differentiation in acute situation, definitely homeopathy can give a better service to the suffering humanity. But we have to know this acute situation, how to tackle and how to take the acute totality on causation basis, on predominating modality and predominating other accessory symptoms. Because even mother is telling, just I'm giving examples that why I'm telling accessory symptoms or other concomitant symptoms, that all of a sudden you are observing that last 3 days the child has developed voracious appetite with coryza. Mother is telling doctor, my child never eats so much, but last 2 days I am observing that his appetite has increased ravenously. And so when coryza, cough, cold, coryza, and with ravenous appetite, we have rubric, and that is the peculiarity that you have to pick up. If it is really a hunger increased during this acute situation, think of sulfuric acid, acid salt, think of ileum sepa, think of fever sulfur. Among these also you have to differentiate. So by this way, more we know that how to tackle the acute situation, cough, cold, coryza, very easily can be controlled, and it is quicker than any other system of medicine. You are observing that a child is during cough, cold, coryza, every time when patient is coughing, he is holding his throat. So you are observing it is a spontaneous reflex. So you can think most probably the child need either ileum sepa or iodine. So these are the peculiar observations which can help in acute situation. So a child is crying, moaning, but along with that the child is carried by the mother, so sweet, just extend your hand, the child is jumping to you with this fever, with this crying. No, but the child is jumping to you, get sympathy. These are better by sympathy, better in company, and with blunt discharge, think of pulsatilla. That even the behavior of the child, sometimes it will give a good clue that how to tackle this cough and cold. The child is extremely irritable, pulling mother's hair, pulling doctor's hair, spitting with cough, cold, coryza, spitting. We can think of either chamomilla or we can think of sina. Mother is telling doctor, even the child cannot talk, but mother is telling doctor, whenever I am putting little bit warm water, my child's cough is better. The child cannot tolerate cold water or normal water, warm water gets relief, and without expectoration, before the midnight aggravation, we can think of a spongia. The mother is telling the doctor, the funny thing is that you are telling to give some warm water, but I am observing that whenever I am, the child rejects the warm water, but drinking, desire to drink cold water. Think of causticum, that cold water emulates. Think of cupra metallicum when it is a spasmodic cough, spasm. So this horrible cough, but when mother is putting either breast milk or mother is putting some water, cough is little bit controlled. Think of cupram metallicum, because we know cupram, like it is the leading medicine, and indication is spasm. No spasm, no cupram. So even the cough, it must be spasmodic. So by this way, we have lots of medicine that can be discussed one after another, that how confidently we can control the acute cough or cold.